Today's topic, wind animation. When working on visualizations or animations, you always try to add the extra details, the extra touch that will make your work more realistic, more interesting, or simply more beautiful. In this video, I will show you how you can do exactly that. Together, we'll create this extremely complex and realistic wind animation from a simple tree model in just 8 minutes. To follow this tutorial, you need a tree model saved in GrowFX format. The first link in the description will link you to the GlowPlants website where you can buy this model. By the way, guys from GlowPlants contacted me with the idea and proposed to sponsor this video. So if you like it, thank them in the comments section. As I mentioned before, the tree is saved in the GrowFX version. GrowFX is a plugin that allows you to create complex plant models. This model has a really nice bark detail, which adds a lot of photorealism. I will remove it though, so it doesn't distract you during this tutorial. We'll be using the newer GrowFX version 2. If the model is saved in the older version, we just need to click this button to convert it. The tree is slightly different. That's the beauty of GrowFX models. You can quickly create different variations of the model. Let me give you a quick introduction to the node editor. Here, we can switch from mesh display to lines display. And here, we can open the node editor. It may look overwhelming at first, but to do wind animation, you don't need to know much about that. This is an individual path trunk in this case, with all associated nodes. Here, we have a first level of branches, and so on. These are the leaves, the last level. Here we can see or change the color of the path, which you can see in the viewport. You get the idea. Here, you can see all the levels highlighted with the corresponding color. You can pause this video and analyze it. Similarly, here is the explanation of the individual level. It's not necessary to understand it for this tutorial, but it's good to have an idea. To make the file faster, we can disable some paths. I will turn off leaves and stems, as the number of them is the largest. We can simply uncheck this option. I will turn off these branches also. Now let's add the wind modifier. Here are direction modifiers. You can go to the last one and add the wind animation here. However, this is not the correct approach, as these modifiers are working on lines and as a result, the mesh is not well done. Instead, we have to add the modifier after mesh. This will give us the correct results. Here is the wind animation modifier node. Firstly, we need to pick the wind object from the scene. If we don't have any, we can create it quickly with this button. Here it is, but we don't see any results. Why is that? It's because the modifier is added after mesh. We have to switch the display to meshes to see the effects. And here it is. As you can see, it's really strong. Let me show you how to control it. The fan size controls only the appearance of the fan in the viewport and doesn't affect animation at all. Then, we have wind speed, which is the most important parameter. Basically, the lower the value, the weaker the wind, and vice versa. Next, let me show you what the K does. You can see this blue gizmo appeared, so basically everything that is inside is affected by wind. If an object or its part is outside, wind animation doesn't work there. I don't use this option very often, but it can be useful in some cases. Next, let's cover the perturb speed option. You can add some variations to the animation with this option. Obviously, it's too strong. We have to lower the speed amount, which controls the maximum speed deviation. Size specifies the size of fractal noise. The larger the value, the less noticeable the effect. The interaction option controls the number of interactions used by the fractal function. An interaction of 1 is the same as turning the fractal off. It will give the smoothest result. With face, you can shift the effect to adjust it to your needs. Perturb vector works very similarly, but affects the direction of the wind instead of speed. It will add another layer of variations to the object. The larger the amount, the more multidirectional the wind is. Here also, the size specifies the size of fractal noise. Larger values will give you a more calm effect. Interaction and phase works with the same logic as with the perturb speed. Moving the fan doesn't affect the animation. Rotating is very important though. It gives us the direction of the wind. let's move on to the path settings. Here we can control the stiffness and flexibility of the path. The stiffness of the path numerically determines the wavelength of the vibrations of paths. To put it simpler, higher numbers will give us stiffer paths, which will result in less noticeable wind animation. It will be harder for the wind to move a path. The flexibility of the path numerically determines the scale of the subsidence under the influence of wind forces. Basically, a larger number will give us a more flexible path. In this tutorial, I won't go deeper into other parameters. You can read more about them on the X-Level website, link in the description. I will just mention that looping animation is a pretty handy option, so you can easily duplicate it without any hard cuts. As we get the basics, let's add the wind modifiers to other paths. I will move them all here, close to each other. I will move stem and leaves modifiers below, so we know what's going on. Next, let's add the same wind object to all the modifiers. This way, we will control the whole tree with just one wind object. Let's disable the leaves and stems again. The file will be faster this way. Now we can adjust the final settings of each path. The general rule is that the larger the branch, the stiffer and less flexible it is. I will enable looping on each modifier. Let's adjust the second level of branches. They will be a bit more flexible. And repeat the same with the other two levels. We can always go back to the wind object and lower the wind speed. It will affect the whole object. Let's turn on the leaves and stems again. Let's adjust the settings. These objects will be less stiff and more flexible. With leaves, you can turn on the axial rotation option. The max angle controls the maximum deflection angle of the axial rotation. I will set it to 70. Now, we'll have fully parametric wind animation on the whole tree. We can easily adjust the wind speed, wind direction, and other parameters. Here is how it looks animated. Again, I highly recommend you check the GrowFX website and play around with their models. If you want to learn all about architectural animations in 3ds Max, join my course or watch other videos on that topic. Bye bye!